Living a life beyond limitation is a free life. A life without struggles, stress, and tension. A life full of abundance and plenty, which every child of God is expected to enjoy. Through divine inspiration, God has used his son, Bright Azubuike, to unveil certain principles to enable Christians live a life beyond limitation. In this book, you will discover truth about understanding God's Word. Why you must work towards your God-given potential. The efficacy of wisdom.
Bright Ikechi Azubuike is a committed servant of God. He bears God-given mandate, which is tagged, inspired to aspire. He labors to establish God's kingdom here on earth. Of Methodist Campus Fellowship at Captain Elechi, Amadi Polytechnic, where he obtained National Diploma in Law. Bright is an active servant of God for a period of 2 years as the PRO. Bright is currently a student of Rivers State University, Port Harcourt.
Ignorance is a modern slavery. So buy this book, it's just a little levy. The bondage that comes with ignorance is so heavy. So get knowledge, it makes you feel curvy and gladdens your heart like a baby. The words I say to you are not just fallacy, they are truth and have energy. And you must adhere to them if you want to live a life of legacy. See, let me take a pause here. See, these days ignorance spreads like chicken pox, and I know when it's time for you to buy this book, most of you will see that as if you have no money in your purse. See, you don't be by force, but it's high time you get up from that door. For me, now must. So just buy this book and be safe. Just give me your trust. See, before I leave you guys, I would like to pass a message, and this is what I do everywhere I go. It's about the mystery of togetherness. The mystery of togetherness is something we should know to cop the misery of loneliness. It is a tool that is stronger than the power of the real highness and has the ability to break you from life barrenness, putting you in a state of everlasting happiness. This rule does not preach selfishness, comes in back against greediness, but trying to walk alone in this life is a sign of madness. See, the act of going through life alone is a philosophy that has been far gone, because when people isolate themselves, it breaks my bone. Always want to fight alone as if they are James Bond. But who will I do to save them from this group? Oh yeah, let's go. See, let me tell you guys something. So your happiness does not lie in your hands, but in the hands of those that are choosing to dance according to the beating of your bands. So now what are you waiting for? Come, let's visit. Now is the season. Don't fight alone. You're not Samson. See, even though you get just like me, that one know me, because not only one person can prepare burial meal. So now what is the deal? Live in happiness. Oh, amen. Thank you very much.
You have bad intentions. Enter van. For it. Your country is very confused.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't travel, go overseas, because yes, I've been travel. I did travel, go to Dubai. You go understand it at the top. You know, say if you travel, go overseas, you go see all these American people with their disease. You know, sound so, if you get a disease, so sweet, but very dangerous. You go fear congestitis. And tell me disease. Because it is sweet name, grandma joint, congestitis, cancer, Ebola, you go like get that name at him. But if you come to Nigeria, you go see name where nothing will do you, but very strong, strong name. Krong. Jadi. Who you left together for Nigeria? And now, ladies and gentlemen, this last one before I leave this stage. Now, you go notice here, if you don't go America again, you go visit your proverbs, very sweet, sweet proverbs. Yes, if you love America, you go get their proverb. Sweet proverb is teach time, says nine. You can't eat your cake and have it back. Take your couple of people to the market and see what they will buy for you. My brothers and sisters, welcome to Nigeria. Your proverb, you must see animal inside your proverb.
Now three, now three, now make market is saying wise. One day market will go market, you know, go come back here. Yeah. When please blow, found in your shoe. Put your hands together, go by the
name of my life. The proverb says, death is not a tragedy of life, but the tragedy of life is a life without a purpose. Such life is not worth living, because it is a life without impact. That paragraph made me to hunger for relevant knowledge towards enabling me to discover my purpose. I prayed to God and I started receiving inspiration from God, and my zeal for writing improved when I came across a scripture, Ecclesiastes 12:12. And further by this, my son, be admonished of making many books. There is no end, and much study is the weariness of the flesh. I did not stop there. I understood the power of Father's blessing. My Father in the Lord was my mentor. I saw the seed and he distributed over my life and blessed me with an oil. And after that day, my grace increased. Then I remembered what my biological father always told me. You can only finish what you have started. The only problem is to keep procrastination and start. Then I started writing my first book. During the period I wrote my first book, I was studying at Harcourt Polytechnic, Robola. During this period of writing, I was so discouraged by words of people around me, to the extent that I felt I was being used by my mentor. They always told me to stop deceiving myself, that this book you are writing will be taken by your mentor one day. And friends and family, to be sincere, it wasn't easy for me because I lost confidence in myself and I was down, but something happened. Guess what happened? I turned their discouraged speech to a motivational speech. I disvalued everything they had to say and believed in God who has given the purpose. I focused on my purpose and became more loyal to my mentor. And after some while, I came up with my first book, Living a Life Beyond Limitation. After that, no money to publish the work. I believe God so much that I don't doubt his capacity. Then I said to myself, I must start. I made contact with my mentor and the number of the editor, Mr. Mike, was given to me. And the process was started. And to cut this short, God perfected everything and crowned the effort of my hands with success. And the vision is a reality today. I must say a big thanks to my family. You are the best, especially for the parental guidance and discipline so far. Indeed, I'm ever grateful. And say thanks to my mentor, Pastor David Etayafe. You have really played a prominent role to make this day a reality. I sincerely thank you. I also thank Mrs. Aigoniwari, who played a vital role to make an advert for me at the press. Also want to thank Ms. Gold for her kindly support for making this day a success. I'm grateful to my friends, especially Comrade John Dionuka, who took part in the first ABT. And my roommates, Amadi, Elechi, Obo, Imade, and my friend, Gift, Obo, that you guys are always. And I want to also thank the committee who effectively planned this occasion. I'm grateful. I must not forget my biological brother, Azubuike Wisdom Chineme, who also made efforts making this day a reality today. I must say I'm blessed to have you as a brother. And also thanks to everyone who has made it possible to be present today. You have also played a vital role to make my vision a reality. I'm a young boy in my 20s who published a book without being in debt. With all humility, God did all. My daily answer in life is, the moment you start anything, God play a prominent role to make you accomplish it. I just want to say this, I don't know what your project may look like. I don't know what your business intends to do may look like. But for you to embrace success, you must keep procrastination. Ladies and gentlemen, to get effective results in anything you are doing, you must start to enable you to get a true blessing. Thank you very much. I remain blessed and connected with God. I remain as you may cry. Thank you so much.
Please put
your
hands together for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I still stand on the existing protocol. But before I make the march, I must say something about the book. Even I'm surprised that a boy, I never knew you're a born again Christian. I never knew you're coming here alive to Christ. I was telling my friend and brother that they are not cured. Because these days, our children are talking of cults, all these useless things. And their children are talking of born again. They are lucky. They are a lucky man. So, my boy, I thank you so much. And of course, you know that in our society, ignorance is a very big disease. And a lot of things, because we don't know God, we don't do those things God said we should do, but we're ignorant of those things. We are being misled. I think if we read that book very well, I perused it, but I didn't go deep, because he brought the book very late to me. If you read that book very well, you will come out of those things that will lead you into ignorance, that will mislead you from not knowing your God and doing those things God says you should do. And for the second book, or the first, I don't know which one, living a life beyond limitation. I know that even though they say there's limit to certainty, but if you know God, you know no limit to anything you are going to do. So I think the title of the two books, to me, has meaning, and it appears very well. And I will enjoy everybody here, and those who didn't come, to buy the book. And this launching we are going to do, don't say because chairman gave 1 naira for that. I have 2 naira in my bag or in my pocket. I will not do more than the chairman. We need to encourage him, the young man, because at this age he has written 2 books, which means by the time he will get to my age and obtain a PhD or become a professor, he is going to do a harvest of just like Professor Timele of UOE. So he's going to have a harvest of books. We'll continue to encourage him. Even after here, it is not going to stop at what we are going to do here today. So, on behalf of myself and my family, though they are not here because of other engagements, such as my wife, I want to launch these 2 books with 30,000 men.
That's awesome. Please celebrate the chairman. Clap for him. That's nice. See, in geography, as I hand over the mic, so the mentor of the author celebrates Pastor David.
Hallelujah. You know that the pastor is always the difference. Amen.
Amen.
Once again, I also want to congratulate my protege, the protege and friend, for how thus far he has brought us close. Really glad, happy, and honored for this day. And like as our shepherd said, it's really a good step, and it's not easy to have gone such far. And with the best we can, we always do well to encourage you. Because we play a major part in publishing the book up to this point. But that notwithstanding, but we still play a very vital part in launching it and still beyond. But on behalf of myself, and I also want you to still see this, which we still do more, because little is much when God is involved. So Lord, as God is involved, is an empowerment, not just for the launching. I also launched the book in 10,000 naira.
Cash. Wow. Please celebrate the mentor of the author. That's amazing. Thank you very much. Please, the band, wait. The spirit of God and that of the band come all together.
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me celebrate Sir Uma Celebrating. It took me time because the money was huge. The money was huge. Don't make noise, don't shout for me. You know, you have some chat.
Thank you. Check this one. I would say today is one of the happiest days in our family. Having a boy, go write what people can read. Now one of the books I read said, if you want to be remembered, if you don't want to be forgotten in this world, do what people can write about, or you write what people can read. If you can do these two things, you will not be forgotten in this our empty world. I thank BRIGH so much for having been inspired, especially in the way of the Lord. And what being inspired and being forgotten about with this, I will launch the two goods with the cash donation of 10,000 naira.
Yes. I told you I was hearing 100 million.
The hands of launching this book, and launching this book with the sum of 10,000 naira.
That's awesome. Please clap. That's wonderful. I told you I left the UK, and he gave me $10,000, and he's giving me 10,000 naira. My money be passing away. You understand? But I must say, there were plenty fast naira. How many of you know? $1 is how much now? $3.65. Imagine, $1 in 1 year. How many of you think
of prayer? Pray the dinner that you are writing to discourage you.
But as long as the friends he has at the time, that give you that moral support.
Yeah. Also want to use this way to thank the Almighty God for making this day a reality. Now if not God, that God would have stopped halfway. Well, as I have frankly said, I have been paying other dues, house rent, school fees,
OTs have passed away.
All those things have passed away.
Yes, sir.
My last hand on a new ground. The land of that development, the struggle continues.
Hello, Pastor.
I want to launch that book. I and my wife, with a sum of 50.
Please celebrate it,
Most persons you see today who are printing millions of books and thousands of books started this way. And I want to say thank you. Most of us today never had this opportunity. Just like a father here, you never had this opportunity. I never had it. But today you had it, you have had it. What I want to tell you is that let nothing stop you. Continue. It pays in the long run. You may not see the glory, the dividends, the gain today, but I want to tell you, as one who has mother track over time, you will always reap. You will always be there to see the advantages of writing books. Most of these books will sell in the internet very soon. You have to create a website where they will be sold in Amazon, in the YouTube, and other platforms. Praise God. And I want to also say that what he has done is worthy of emulation. Most of us here, young ones coming up, emulating, do much better and write books. They will stand over time when you are no more here on planet Earth. People will always talk about you. Like when we read Chinechebe's books, we will also read Katz and other writers. Even Shakespeare, over 200-300 years, he wrote books. we are still reading his books today. And Shakespeare never dies, because those books can never be eroded completely. Praise God. Praise Master Jesus. And I want to also encourage and say thank you to Mr. Matisyogu, the father and the mother, who have supported him, who have known the importance of writing books, and said, my son, go ahead. Many of us started this way, but we are not encouraged. And today, there is nothing to show forth. Today you have started, you can look back and see books you have written, and you'll be glad. Go ahead with it, it will pay. In the reality, your things will work well, and most of these books will be sold very well. And I want to say, myself and my wife over there, I can't let her have sat at the same time or at the same place with her. We run so many outfits. We run Anu Place International Logistics. She is the deputy director, I am the director. We run Anu Place Real Estates, Anu Place International Schools. Praise God. Many of you will grow to be pushers, to be capitalists. As a political scientist, I can dash my hand into vocabularies of political science and displays of acrobatic grammatical expressions. And I owe nobody any apology. Praise God. Praise God. Today, I want to see and I want to say that in our domestic capitalist economy, unlike what happens in the British state of sight, today there is a new sight of things. Poverty has gone away in Nigerian society, especially in the south here. Unlike apostates, we want to say and launch this book with the sum of thousands and thousands of naira you are going to see here. I don't want to mention so that I don't intimidate anyone. Praise God. It may run in dollars or whatever you see. Take care.
Please clap. Clap. Celebrating. I love this man. That guy loves you. You know why I love you? I think he kidnapped us, don't you?